Praise the Lord, precious saints, and welcome to another daily prophetic utterance to start your day. The Lord is saying today, my child, your life is my platform, and I have positioned you for such a time as this. Your history does not define your future destiny, my child, for what I have for you is bigger than you. For with me, nothing is impossible, as I can use even the most flawed and unlikely individuals to bring about my purpose. For I am the refiner's fire, and I will sanctify your life as you submit to me daily. Therefore, do not allow your past to discourage you from taking the bold steps towards the plans that I have for your life, my child. Remember that there is no storm that I will not carry you through. There is no bridge that I will not help you cross. There is no battle that I will not help you win. There is no burden that is too heavy that I have not promised to lift from you, my child. Remember, I am so much bigger than anything that you may be facing today. Therefore, get your eyes on me. My child, when I become your all in all, only then will you understand what it means to live for me. Yes, it is in this intimacy that you desire me and walk with me. As Enoch walked with me, I desire for you to walk in deeper intimacy with me, my child, through the power and help of my spirit. Remember, I am a loving God and not a slave master. Yes, my child, I am the God of more than enough, and in me and through me you shall have overflowing peace, overflowing joy, overflowing abundance, overflowing love, overflowing anointing, overflowing of blessing. And I will never stop at enough, for I will overflow, my child. Yes, all those that truly hunger and thirst for my righteousness will always be filled each and every day. Yes, anyone that comes to me will never be disappointed, turned away or put to shame, for I am your God and I am jealous after you. Therefore, let your cup overflow today as you spend time in my presence, for I have more than enough to share with you today, my child. Therefore, don't let the devil tell you that I just want to give you enough or stay in want. I don't just desire to give you enough, but rather more than enough, for in me you are complete, my child. I desire for you to grow in me more each day, that you will understand that my love, my joy, my abundance, my anointing, my presence, my peace and blessings are greater than your capacity to even understand or contain it, my child. My overflow is not limited to what your vessel can hold. Rather, for when I pour out from my overflow, I will pour out an overflow that you won't have room enough to receive. Have I not said that when you learn to give, it shall be given to you, my child? Yes, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Therefore, do not limit me in your thinking, but know that I am the God of limitless. My child, you have been hand-picked for a special mission that only you can complete, as you are uniquely made by me. Therefore, you must spend more time in the overflow of my presence to receive the special detailed instructions that I have for you. So be mindful of the company that you keep, my child, because the company that you keep can influence you in the positive or the negative. That's why as you spend more time with me, you'll become more like me. But when you spend more time with the people of this world, there will be other transference of the spirit of this world that will influence your decision making. Therefore, always look to me in spending your time. I want my overflow to be poured out upon all those that are thirsty, my child. Yes, it shall also flow upon all those that I place around you, that they also may taste and see that I am good. As you yield your vessel to me daily, I will overflow to those that are going through difficult times. My desire is that as you spend more time with me, and my love will overflow more and more from your life. Yes, my child, for I want you to understand that what really matters in this life, so that you may live pure and blameless lives until my return. Therefore, if anyone desires to come after me, they must deny themselves and take up their cross daily and follow me. For whoever wishes to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for my name's sake and my gospel will save it, my child. I have given you grace this day to overcome all obstacles, no matter what is coming against you, my child. Therefore, learn to speak my word and promises each and every day. For when you truly believe something, you will also start to declare it with your mouth also. And as you do so, I will answer your heart's desires. I am coming back soon, and I desire to fill my remnant with my spirit in this hour. I desire to fill you with my joy and peace as you continue to trust in me, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of my spirit. Know that I am for you. Know that I am with you, my child. Be at peace this day, my child. Shalom. Praise the Lord, precious saints. The Bible says, according to 1 Corinthians 15, verse 33 onwards, it says, "Do not be deceived. Bad company ruins good morals. Wake up from your drunken slumber, as is right, and do not go on sinning, for some have no knowledge of God. I say this to your shame." So, how many times have we heard that old saying as growing up? It may sound silly, but you know by the company you keep. That might sound silly to some of us, but it only takes a moment to realize how true it is. Maybe that realization comes after getting arrested for being at a party or with underage drinking. Like in my case, I did a lot of silly things when I was young because of bad company. Or maybe it comes when we find ourselves the subject of gossip among the friends that we usually gossip with. Or maybe the truth of that statement hits us hard when we are passed over for a promotion because our co-workers' negative attitude influence us to stop caring and trying at work like we once did. So do not be misled. Bad company corrupts good character. Come back to your senses as you ought and stop sinning, for there are some who are ignorant of God. I say this to your shame. So community is a choice. We choose to invest in friendships that are beneficial and help us to be better followers of Jesus. Or we can choose to invest in the friendships that would take us further away from Jesus Christ. So one of the best investments that you can make, it is in friendships that encourage you to be more like Jesus Christ. So the Lord has given us great opportunities that He will send people along your way, whether it's on social media, whether it's in church, whether it's wherever it is, God will send those people to come along. When you are in deep friendships, you're able to share life struggles, and you can also encourage one another. So you can also learn to speak in love and share also disappointments and victories with each other. But what kind of person do you want to be? Are you surrounding yourself with the friendships that could help you become that person? One of the best investments that you can make is in friendships that encourage you to be more like Jesus Christ. Are there any friendships that you need to invest more in? Are there any friendships that you need to invest less in? And what is one step that you can take today to be more like Jesus Christ in your friendships? You got to ask the Lord this. See, friendships, there is a transference of spirits, as we've seen from today's word. So we must be very careful of what we do and who we hang around. Doesn't mean we're not to be the light of Christ to people, but it's like we are supposed to be like fire lighters, not fire extinguishers. Fire lighters go and start fires, and then they come away. They start fires. You've got to start the fire of God's love and passion within the hearts of people. So let us read this. Isaiah 53 verse 4 says, "Surely He took up our sicknesses and carried our sorrows." Mark 9:23 says, "Everything is possible for him who believes." Romans 15 verse 13 says, "May the God of hope fill you with all joy, peace, as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit." Hallelujah. Precious saints, there is nothing impossible for God to bring about His purpose within your life, but you've got to learn to trust in Him. Allow Him to separate you from anyone that could be of a bad influence for you, and allow Him to send His divine helpers. Allow Him to send those people that will influence you to run the course of this race that we're on today. So let us pray now, precious saints. So Heavenly Father, we thank You in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Please give us the spirit of wisdom and revelation. Open the eyes of our heart to know the hope and power by which You want us to live. Thank You, Lord. Lord, we thank You that You'll help us to cultivate the simplicity of devotion to You. We want You to be our primary, ambition within this life. We desire to behold Your beauty and dwell in Your house all the days of our life. Let seeking Your heart be the goal of our life, even in our busy and stressful times. Help us to be one who seeks. Help us to discover Your emotions and purposes of Your heart. We want to be a lover of God and thirsty after You daily. That's right. Keep us, Lord, as the apple of Your eye. Hide us in the shadow of Your wings. Teach us how to align our heart with Yours. Lord, we pray that we recommit ourselves, Lord, after Your heart, and we choose to seek Your face. In difficult times, open our heart to receive Your revelation. Hide us in the shelter of Your tabernacle. Reveal deeply to our hearts Your love for us, and rescue us in the midst of difficult circumstances, and bring us into a spacious place. Teach us to enjoy life the way You desire, and we choose to be confident in Your love, for we are, Lord, we thank You that we are Your bride, and we want to prepare for that day. Lord, we pray today, Lord, we love You, O Lord. Give us that strength. Lord, one thing that we ask from You, Lord, is that we seek You, Lord, that we may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of our life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord and to seek Him in His temple. For in the day of trouble, He will keep us safe in His dwelling. Lord, He will hide us in the shelter of His tabernacle and set us on a high rock. Lord, that we are confident of this. Lord, that we will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the the living. Lord, we pray that we wait for the Lord. Be strong and take courage and wait for the Lord. We pray this today that we may know you more, that we may draw nearer to you, that Lord, as we draw nearer to you, we will work also from the overflow. Lord, the abundance, for you're the God of more than enough, and you want to pour out your blessings upon each person today as they receive this word, as they draw closer to you and work from the abundance of your presence. Lord, we desire you today. Fill us, for our cup, Lord, may be empty, but we want it not only to be filled, we want it to be overflowing. Lord, let your overflowing love, abundance, and blessings rest upon us today as we seek you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrowpath Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom. And if you've liked this utterance today, we encourage you, subscribe to our YouTube channel. We can also forward it to a friend right now. And don't forget, you can follow us on Facebook or Instagram. And don't forget, also on our website, repentancerevival.com. Precious saints, I would also like us to pray in particular for South Africa. There is a lot of uproar and riots and looting and even killing going on over there at this present time. And we need to be praying for Africa in particular, because what is starting there could also affect other nations. We've also seen the recent issues in Swaziland and some other places also. So I would just encourage you to pray, because truly we are in the end times, and it's only God that can bring peace to people that are acting in certain ways. So Lord, I pray for South Africa at the moment. Lord, we pray for peace within this nation. Peace within this nation, Lord, that the looting would stop, the killing would stop. Lord, I pray for peace within the hearts of men. Lord, that you would protect each and every innocent person, especially those that listen to this channel. Be with them this day, also in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Cover their homes, cover their belongings, cover their businesses, cover their families, their loved ones, and so forth, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray and believe. Amen. Precious saints, this weekend is it. It is the final finale for the 3 days of pulling down strongholds. Yes, strongholds are going to come tumbling down. I encourage you to participate at whatever level, precious saints. Don't just anticipate, but participate. And please take the time to read this particular blog, all the program, because it is so jam-packed with information. It's going to take you more than 3 days to probably read it. So I encourage you to start now. Get in touch now. Get tapped into the anointing right now as you read the introduction, as you get set, as you choose how you will fast. How are you going to fast? Are you going to choose to go to full fast? Are you going to choose to do a water fast? Are you going to choose to do a partial fast between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. or even 10 p.m. and 6 p.m.? Whatever times, whatever it is, you've got to calculate. You've got to work out how this fast is going to suit you. So from my family to yours, God bless you. We love you. We are praying for you, precious saints. Shalom, shalom, shalom.